This is a WNY News Now investigative report.
A neighborhood is divided. A neighborhood that was once quiet, was once serene, was once peaceful, is now being torn apart by that woman, according to neighbors. Heather Peters is a woman who's owned her home for 14 years in this neighborhood. She says CPS has been called an ungodly amount of times to her home, all reports unfounded.
All of those reports also have been unfounded, stating I'm leaving my children unsupervised, that I'm an unfit mother, so on and so forth. And they're CPS is wasting their time coming to houses like mine where everything is visibly okay. There's, you know, people, children and adults in this community that need help, and they're wasting their time here at my house. But she does things to draw the children to her, and then he comes inside in tears and is terrified because he's afraid that she's going to do something to hurt her or hurt him, and I have to constantly reassure him, you know, that I will try to keep him safe to the best of my ability.
Nikki Ormsby lost her home in July to a hellacious fire. She thought she found a sanctuary on this street in August. She thought wrong.
We were homeless, so we took the house. We took the chance. We're nice people. We were nice. And till my kids started being harassed by her. And I started being harassed by her every day. Now, I'm almost 40 years old. I have no criminal background. I've never been arrested. I've never been in trouble with the police. Until now, I've had the police at my house 5 or more times within a month. And I've had CPS at my house 3 times because of my neighbor across the street.
Now, Dolores Bemis claims she mentored 53-year-old Mary McNamara. Dolores says she actually was placed on probation by Jamestown City Courts for 6 months just a few years ago after she caught a harassment charge.
I was arrested.
And they said that I painted that sign and it was in front of my house, the investigator said. And I done 6 months on harassment. Really? The only harassment I done was I called her a hoe. Yeah. She is. I was like a mother for her for 3.5 years. She is a practical, she's doing business now, still now. I don't mean to be mean to Mary. She needs help. She is not crazy. She knows exactly what she's doing. She's crazy, like we say, like a fox. There was a bunch of kids over here playing football, and the ball kicked over onto her. She picked it up and took a butcher knife, stabbed it. Cops wouldn't do nothing.
Now, Mary McNamara came home, and she obviously didn't want to talk to us. About 15 minutes later, the Jamestown Police Department came up to us. They wanted to know where we were parked. They said they got a report of somebody blocking the driveway. Reporting from Hammond Street, where this neighborhood is clearly divided between good and bad. I'm Ryan Hedrick, WNY News Now, where coverage comes first.